Good morning and welcome to the CREC Athletic League Middle School Championship basketball game. My name is Al Collins.
My name is Mike Collins. It should be a great matchup today. Undefeated MLC versus the Academy of the Arts.
And we have the starting lineup. Let's give a listen.
Welcome to tonight's game between the MLC Dragons and GHAA Lady Pirates. We view our gym as an extension for our classroom environment where we learn dignity and respect for others. Tonight, we ask you for your enthusiastic, positive support for your respective team.
We also ask that you support the student athletes from both schools by honoring our request to treat all of the athletes, coaches, and officials with respect. Thank you.
Now it's time for our starting lineups. First, for the home team, the Arts Academy Lady Pirates. Starting at guard, number 23, Tara Fair. Also starting at guard, number 12, Victoria Vasquez. Starting at forward, number 22, Tisha Parks. Starting at forward, number 21, Aisha Williams. And starting at center, number 24, Olivia Kostecki. Now our starting lineups for the MLC Lady Dragons. Starting at guard, number 11, Abigail Ann Branson. Also starting at guard, number 13, Tyra Anderson. Starting at guard, number 15, Tierra Turner. Starting at forward, number 21, Amani Leviton. And starting at center, number 10, Marissa Lee. We now have a special treat for you. The Arts Academy team is going to sing the national anthem. They can come to the center court, please.
Wow, Mike, you're gonna play and sing.
Call that multitasking. Best half anthem I've ever heard in my life.
It works for me. Well, these ladies look like they're ready to go.
Well, being around the girls team, usually we share court when we have practices. I can tell they're really hyped up. They're ready for this game.
Should be an exciting event here this morning.
Coach Macaroon, hype them up a little bit before the game starts. And here come the starters.
Meeting with the reps and getting everything going here, shaking hands. There goes the game ball.
And when we start the game, keep an eye out on number 21. She usually wears number 26. Her name is Amani Leviton. Really, really excellent talent on this team. She could probably play for the high school team.
I tell you, I watched her the other night. That was phenomenal.
Just one of those players that can really take over a game.
And that's what she did the other night.
Mm-hmm.
That's probably 95% of the reason why they're here this morning.
Yep.
Pirates have already taken the court, waiting for the Dragons. They're still talking it over.
We like to be fashionably late at MLC.
Yeah, she hasn't got here yet. She's in route.
I don't believe these two teams have met at all this year, so it should be an interesting matchup.
Very interesting. We're starting with 8 minutes on the clock. And we're off.
Okay, the Arts wins the tip-off. And they earn a really quick layup. That only took 6 seconds.
Oh, yeah, here we go. 7:51 on the clock. 2-0, the Pirates.
Ball goes out to Levitin. Little hook shot. Remnants of Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. There we go.
And the Dragons are on the board. 2-2, 7:34 on the clock.
Number 13, that was Tyra Anderson with the jump shot.
We got a jump ball.
Here comes point guard Tierra Turner. Passes it off right in the middle of the lane to Levitin. Nice shot. Oh, just not enough.
Whoa, here come the Pirates. Oh.
Oh, stolen and stolen again.
Oh,
gotta
nice
help her out back there.
Set up there. Yep.
Here's Abby with the shot. She's fouled.
Man, we got a foul.
Abby Abramczyk. She will shoot for two.
6:05 on the clock, 2-2, Ms. Bramsick at the line. She misses the first. See if she got it on the second. Looks back at coach. A little extra advice going on there.
Got to fight through those distractions.
Ooh, she misses both. And the Pirates are on their way up the court.
Tierra Turner playing excellent defense.
Oh, my gosh. She's
smothering
right there.
Defense.
She's on him.
That was a great job by Tierra Turner. She really forced that turnover.
Tell you, I've been watching Tierra for a couple years. She's an excellent player.
She's a former softball player of mine, and she is definitely an excellent athlete.
Definitely an All-American, if I say so myself. She plays in every season.
Mm-hmm. A steal and another steal. Both teams illustrating the hands of thieves here today. Nice inbounds play by the Academy of the Arts. I think that's a reach in foul on Levitin.
She needs to stay out of foul trouble early. They need her, so she definitely needs to be careful out there.
Absolutely. If you're the coaches right now, you're pulling her aside to remind her she's the backbone of the team. They can't lose her to foul trouble early on.
Well, Tara's fighting here. There she is.
Just rushed the pass a little bit too much there. Abby did a nice job there.
Oh, we got a little walk call.
Help defense. We like to see that.
.524 in the first, still 2-2.
Academy of the Arts bench is really into the game right now. MLC has to step it up here.
Oh, Tierra's a little frustrated.
And there we go. That's Levitin.
Oh,
she just
Levitin
misses the layup.
Rolled around the rim and out.
Some nice passing there by the MLC offense.
Coach Macaron calling for the stack.
Oh, look at this. Some trickery over here on the MLC side. Just doesn't pay off for them this time.
There it is. Great. Oh!
That was a smart play by Tierra Turner, not jumping up there and fouling. Good job.
And there she goes again. She's got to slow it down. Tierra Turner's got
it. Good look. Over to Levitin. That's an easy shot. She's fouled.
She's fouled. Oh, Mike, as I look over at the scores table, looks like my timekeeper's just arrived.
Like I said, MLC, we're fashionably late.
Oh, yes.
I think she's wearing the Bred Jordan, so yes, very fashionably late.
Yes, she is. That's Miss Monique Davis.
Good job. Hits the first free throw.
4:52 on the clock in the first. The Pirates 2, MLC Dragons 3. And she sinks the second free throw.
Nothing but
two
net.
Dragons.
That perfect form on those free throws. Oh, almost had that one. Sierra Turner again playing smart defense. Good job, ladies.
Don't fight, Victoria. Jump up. Get a foul.
4:38 on the clock. 2-4 MLC Dragons.
Oh, very nice passing cut. Just wasn't there.
Oh, they got it back. Nobody. Oh, they're fighting for it.
They might have gotten away with that one.
Well, that was definitely a friggin' foul. All right, here comes
here
the Dragons.
Here comes Levitin.
There's Levitin.
Oh,
are
she
we ready?
Just beat everybody
and
down the court.
And there she is, coast to coast.
Absolutely.
2-6, 4-8 on the clock in the first.
On defense, keep an eye on number 13, Tyra. She's really doing a good job taking the ball away.
Oh, yeah. She's definitely on her game today.
Shot attempt, no good. Oh, she's fouled on the putback. And that will be number 12, Victoria Vasquez, shooting 2.
She's going to the line.
That's the way to do it.
3:52 on the clock, 2-6 MLC Dragons. Great Hartford Academy is at the line. She misses the first. She misses
the second.
There
was a foul on the rebound down there. Just a little too physical down there.
3:51 on the clock, 2-6 Dragons. Tierra Turner, she's calling out the calls. Careful, not a travel. Whoa!
Oh, Levitin has the ball. Better watch out. She's tripped up right at the line there.
And she gets a foul.
Greater Arts Academy doing a nice job trapping the player on the sideline who receives the ball. They're really keeping a heads-up defense out there. Again, stolen away by Tyra.
Well, here comes Greater Hartford Academy out of the yards. Victoria Vasquez with the ball.
What Tierra a look
Turner.
By Tierra Turner.
Turner. Oh, Levitin's got to be. Ooh.
Just couldn't handle that pass, but that was a great look by Tierra Turner.
Very good.
Ooh, just barely held that pivot. Oh, got to be careful.
Number 21, Asia Williams.
Oh, I think it's going to be staying the same way.
Staying the same way. Great offense still has the ball. 2:56 on the clock. 2-6.
That's a great pass down low. Just can't hit those layups today. Got to step up on defense here. Oh.
And we got a foul.
Both teams playing very hard. It seems like the referees are allowing it a little bit.
It looks like they're letting the girls play.
Mm-hmm.
2:44 on the clock. 2-4 Dragons.
I always like it when the games are decided on the floor, not at the free throw line.
Oh,
so
yeah.
A little bit of physicality, I think that's a good thing for the game.
Exactly.
Is that a trick rim? Did we get that from a circus?
Yeah, it looks that way. All right.
What
look
a look
at
Tierra.
To Tierra
Turner. That was a great job.
And she sinks it.
Smart heads up play.
2:35 on the clock. 2-8 MLC Dragons. Here comes the Pirates.
That was a good job of quickly getting the ball and immediately releasing it.
Excellent job. Dakota Rawls with the ball. She shoots for the three. She misses. Oh, Asia Williams fights for the ball, and she's got a foul.
Amani getting tossed around down here early. She's got to save her strength for the fourth quarter.
.214 on the clock, 2-8, the Dragons.
This is a basketball game, not a football game.
All right.
Crowd seems a little unnerved by all the physicality in the.
Oh, that was a first.
A little bit. Team that plays like that, you can tell they really want it.
Oh, yeah.
Number 21, Asia Williams. She's at the line for two. She misses the first with 2:05 on the clock. 2:08, and we have a sub coming in for the Dragons.
Looks like it's Jayla Turner, number 20.
I think that's Tierra's little sister. Matter of fact, it is Tierra's little sister.
I learn something new every day. I had no idea.
Oh, yeah. Got both Turners on the court.
Tyra Anderson with the. Oh,
and
look at that
Tierra
look at Tierra again.
Same spot.
She
takes it again.
Tierra's doing an excellent job getting the ball quickly.
She knows how to get down to the end of that court.
She turns around and immediately shoots that layup. Doesn't waste any time. That's a nice job.
I tell you, Mike, that's a big difference when we saw the Lady Dragons the other night
Absolutely.
With the high school team.
Yep. The high school team couldn't pull that playoff, but they kept trying it. It's being really effective for MLC thus far.
Very effective. Well, Mike, your boys are going to be taking the court in about an hour.
Yes,
what are your
thoughts? I think if they play the way they did against the last team they played, who was it? Who did we play? I'm so nervous about the game, I couldn't even remember.
Engineering.
It was Aerospace Jets. If they play the way they played against the Jets, they should have no problem winning this game. It's all about heart and determination. They played the right way for all 32 minutes.
Good, they did an excellent job. I must say congratulations to you on that.
Thank
fine
you.
Fine job. You guys did excellent with that.
Just as a coach, I've never been so proud in my life.
Yeah, you guys did an excellent job with that. It was a fine job. Look forward to seeing you. Coach McElroy is going to be joining me at the table a little later. There's Ms. Douglas. Good morning.
Yeah, we're facing two Rivers who we didn't see at all this year. So, again, should be a very interesting game. Oh, it's coming back. Going the other way.
It's going the other way. 1:40 on the clock. 2:10. The Dragons are still leading. All right, there's Tierra. Oh, wow, she's bringing up the ball this time. They kind of changed it up a little bit, Mike.
Well, they took Abby out, and they replaced her with Tierra's sister, and now they're going to have Tierra work the point.
Smart move. I tell you, Coach Woodfield's doing an excellent job of moving these girls around the court.
Well, the score reflection, it's 10-2 early on. If they keep it up, you know, you don't want to let the team jump back into the game. Then
not
the crowd gets involved, then you get unnerved. So if you just keep the pressure on,
and that's kind of one of the things that happened on the other night when we were here, Thursday night, I believe. I'm sorry, Tuesday night.
Yep. No, a lot of teams, they jump out early and then they let up a little bit. Teams that don't let up are the teams that win.
Exactly. Number 12.
That was a nice adjustment by number 12. She almost got trapped on that baseline. She was able
Victoria
to get out of it.
Vasquez. All right, there's Tierra. She's trying to get it together. It's now 4:10, 1-on-1 on the clock.
MLC needs a bucket here. You don't want them to score more than three buckets in a row.
A little sister-sister action there.
Yep. Oh. The Arts Academy really putting the pressure on here. It's a good shot.
Good shot.
I think it's going to stay the same way. Nope, it's coming back.
It's coming back.
All right, let's see how MLC responds to this pressure because it seems like the Academy of the Arts are really stepping up the defense.
Almost definitely. And they're moving pretty fast up the court.
Oh, Tierra just a little excited over there. Yep.
Oh, I missed that one. Did you see that one, Mike?
Yeah, she's a terrific athlete, but she gets really into
it, really
into the game emotionally.
Into the game.
So she just got a little bit too physical there on defense.
She's coming back MLC way.
Now, those kind of plays, the jump balls where you grab the ball and you're kind of fighting for it,
right.
It might seem like it's not a basketball play. It is. It's very important to the game that you jump on that ball because these possessions can determine a game.
Oh, most definitely.
Oh, excellent steal down there. Number 23.
Tierra
Fair.
Isn't this interesting? We got a 23 Tierra,
yep.
MLC, and also Greater Hartford Academy of the Arts, they also have a 23
it's one
Tierra.
Of those strange sports coincidences.
Oh, yeah. Both carrying the same number, 23. No, I'm sorry. Turner's 15.
Our Turner's 15, yep.
28.1 seconds on the clock, 4:10 MLC.
Taking the time at the line.
Ooh.
It's a violation. Got to hit that rim. Okay, 27 seconds. I would imagine we're going to set up for one last shot. Let's see what they do.
There it is. There's Tierra Turner. Oh, the ball stolen. Whoa. She's got to be careful, Mike. She's very excited. She's getting too aggressive out there. She's got to be careful. Coach definitely needs to talk to Tierra Turner.
Here comes Imani. Oh, just missed.
Just missed it.
And she's fouled on the putback. 5 seconds left. Now, what it looks like is developing here is the Academy of the Arts is starting to pick up on the strategy of MLC. MLC's trying to get that ball into Imani.
Right.
So I'm hoping they don't make the same mistake that the high school girls made, where they're running the same play over and over, because this team will pick up
on it. They pick up on it pretty quick.
Mm-hmm.
Five 5.4 seconds on the clock in the first. 4:10, MLC Dragons.
Gonna talk it over on the sidelines.
Little table talk. And they missed both.
Almost hit that shot, but another quick putback. 2 seconds
still
left.
Got it.
And that'll do it.
And that'll do it. We wrap up the first quarter with 4:10.
Tierra needs to calm down on defense.
Tierra's definitely got to calm down a little bit. Hope who talks to her. She's getting just a little too aggressive.
Yep.
A little too aggressive out there.
You like to see the physicality in the game, but you got to be smart about it. You don't want to foul out early on.
You got to be smart about it. Yep. A little earlier.
And the refs are getting some reffing advice from the crowd.
Always seems to be the case. Oh, the ref comes over to talk to the crowd. Now, that's the first.
The meeting of the minds here.
The meeting of the minds here. That's the first.
I can tell you from a coaching perspective, and Al, I'm sure you know this, as a coach of the MLC middle school boys team last year, sometimes we get some advice on how to coach from the sidelines.
We've got a whole bunch of that.
You just got to laugh it off sometimes.
Yeah, that's what you have to do. We're going into the second, 7 minutes on the clock, 4:10 MLC Dragons.
Eagerly awaiting the arrival of assistant coach Santi later on. He'll be here in time for the middle school boys game.
Well, as always, MLC fashion has got to be fashionably late. And I'm sure he'll join us at the table before the end of this game, I'm sure.
And MLC girls look a little lethargic coming out. They better step it up.
All right,
this is the championship
girls.
Game. All right, ball's in 11 and back to Turner.
Passing around.
Anderson back to Turner.
Oh, that was a nice pass.
Back to Little Turner. And that shot is rejected.
Oh, that was just awesome. That was awesome. All right, here they come.
Okay, we got the Academy of the Arts coming back the other way.
There it is. It's up. No.
Oh, there's a lot of white jerseys down there. Oh, she's wide open, but oh, good move there. Tierra stopped that ball from coming in. She had that lane.
Bad lane.
Tried it again, didn't quite pull it off.
All right, ball still going that way. 6:29 on the clock, 4-10 MLC Dragons.
Okay, let's try this a third time. Again, nice defense by Tierra Turner.
Yeah. I don't know, I kind of saw that foul.
Gotta stay away from that sideline.
I saw that foul.
Okay, it's gonna be an inbounds play on the sideline. Tierra Turner.
Tierra Turner knocks it out.
Not letting it happen. A little coaching advice from Mac. Okay, let's see her jump around, jump around. Almost.
Ooh. 6:23 on the clock in the second, 4-10 MLC Dragons. Oh, another whistle.
Yeah, we got seven fouls on MLC, so it's going to be a 1-1. This is what we were talking about earlier, yeah, getting into foul trouble early.
We get that early, early. Here we go. We're in the second quarter, 17 fouls. Wow.
Yep. You want the team to earn their points, but not on the line.
Ref talking to Tierra Turner.
It's a violation. MLC's got to make something happen here.
They got to make something happen, definitely. 4-10, 6:23 on the clock in the second.
Oh, she stopped her dribble.
There it is.
Here comes Levitin. Almost.
Oh, that would have been pretty.
See, now Levitin's a great player, but if they catch on to the fact that she's going to shoot it a lot,
right,
she's not going to get a lot of open shots.
Nope, she's not.
They're going to be all over her, so we got to utilize other players. That'll bring Tara Fair up for another 1-1 shot. And there's still 6 minutes left in this quarter, so you really got to be careful about these fouls. Otherwise,
oh, yeah,
they're gonna
you definitely got to be careful.
The game
with
will
it.
Be decided right here at the line. You don't want that.
There we go. 5-10, 6:01 on the clock. She's got one more at the line.
Yep, don't give them freebies. Great
oh,
shot.
She shakes them both. It's now 6-10 with 6:01 on the clock.
All right.
And, Mike, this is what we're talking about. Mm-hmm. A couple mistakes, they can walk you down.
Yep, and that's a travel. Just a little bit.
So this is what
there.
We're talking about. Mm-hmm. A couple mistakes, and here we go. They start walking them down.
It's only a 4-point lead. If they get a basket here, you cut it down to two. The crowd's really into it. You don't want to give them that momentum.
Exactly.
Got to be careful here. No fouls.
No, it can't be any fouls. Can't be any fouls. You got to be careful.
She stuck.
She kept her eyes on the ball.
Oh.
And there's a whistle on the play.
That was an excellent job. Tyra Anderson playing really good defense today.
And she gets two shots. She's at the line.
Mm-hmm. That's good defense because she's not getting into foul trouble. She does a really good job with her hands swiping the ball away.
Oh, most definitely.
She reminds me of my point guard, Ryan Bettis Allen.
Oh,
very,
yes.
He's really good with his hands. He doesn't get called for fouls.
We got 5:41 on the clock, 6:10. MLC's at the line. Second shot. She misses both. Well, they got the rebound.
Oh, almost became a three-point play. And another steal.
Oh,
here comes Levitin.
Steal. There's Levitin.
Easy layup. Oh,
this
we got to hit that backboard.
Okay, they can't smile.
They got to watch these fouls
watch the
again.
Foul. There's the foul. And it's in and out. Sometimes they just don't go in. And she's up with it again.
Got to get those rebounds.
They still got the ball.
If you notice what Tyra did there, she ran up, stuck her chest out, and just put her hands up. She didn't swipe.
Exactly.
That's perfect defense, especially for the situation that they find themselves in.
Exactly.
Oh, those hands. She's a thief out there. Three-second call. Got to dance in and out of that paint.
Most definitely. 5:04 on the clock. 6:10, MLC Dragons. Couple quick mistakes, and we can have a serious problem.
Absolutely.
Here.
Hold your dribble. Oh,
and that
she
was
walks.
A travel. I saw that one right in front of us, Mike.
Yep, I think it's just the excitement of the game. They're kind of just really into it.
I think MLC needs, he just did. I was going to say he needs to call a timeout, and he just
did. Got to regroup.
Yep, 4:54, 57 on the clock, 6:10.
Good, how are you?
Good. Are we doing okay? I just finally, there's a zillion ways to get into this building.
I know, I'm parked, hopefully.
We're back to action here. MLC is just doing a little regrouping. They're going to come back on the floor. Looks like they're probably going to have another game plan ready. It was an important timeout because you really want to break that momentum.
You got to move around, girls, okay? Yeah.
Don't pick the middle. Here we go. 4:53 on the clock.
Oh, she traveled. Yep. Got to watch that pivot.
Got to watch. 4:52 on the clock. And we got 6:10 MLC Dragons. Like I said, this can go either way. Couple quick mistakes. Mm-hmm. And
it's only 4 points.
Oh, yeah. Well, that was a trick pass there.
Here comes Tyra Anderson, coast to coast, absolutely.
Ooh.
Almost. Abby looked like she wanted to take that shot first, but she has that pass-first mentality, which is a good thing to have on a player. But sometimes you got to trust your shot and take that shot.
You got to. You got to.
All right, Levin stepping up on defense. Got to watch her fouls. It's a good job there. Good job.
Nice rebound.
Okay, here comes Tyra Anderson.
Look at that pass.
Almost. She's getting tossed around today.
And they take it.
They got the put back, but they got to watch it with her.
Got to watch it. I kind of thought that was a foul myself.
Yeah, she got a little physical there. This is even football.
That's right. 4:16 on the clock, 6:12 MLC Dragons.
Tyra Anderson, in my opinion, the first half's MVP. Between her defense and her dribbling ability, she's been great today. 4:07 on the clock. It's 12-6 MLC.
Yeah, 19 fouls for MLC, 6 for Greater Hartford Academy.
Yeah, this is where it becomes. I mean, you have 4 minutes where you really have to play super cautious defense.
Exactly. See Coach Woodfield looking up at the fouls on the
one
board there.
One more foul on us, it becomes 2 shots.
Yes, sir.
That's a great putback.
Wow, did you see that?
Yes, I did. Good heads-up play.
4 minutes left on the clock.
Number 23. Arts Academy really stepping up their defense here. Almost. They got lucky there.
They did.
Well, mini Turner. Back to Levinen.
Yes, she is. It's Levinen. They're double teaming her. She needs to get out of that.
I think she reached in. See, in a situation like this where you have a star player like Levinen who has a really nice shot and she can penetrate, if you're the other players, you really want to set screens to create a little space for her to work.
Most definitely. 3:39 on the clock, 8:12 MLC Dragons, and Asia Livington's at the line for two. Ooh, it's a sinks one.
Got that nice 13-8. Backspin on that foul shot. Gotta be careful here, no violations. There
she
we go.
Sinks both of them. It's now 14-8 MLC Dragons with 3:38 on the clock in the second.
Arts Academy gotta be thinking, you don't wanna send her to the line. Good step up defense there. And the foul, and it counts, and they get a shot afterward. Could be a 3-point play here. And that's their 10th foul. Any foul from this point on, they're shooting two.
Two, that's right. Coach needs to talk to him. Mm-hmm. I see Coach Macaron. She's down at the end of the line. She's, I think that's what she's warning him of. And they sink a 3-point. It is now 11-14 MLC Dragons. Lady Dragons have got to be very careful from this point
on.
That
lead can easily slip away.
They got to be careful.
All right,
staying the same. Very good.
Those kind of jump balls, they're good plays, but you got to be careful of those fouls. You have 10 now. You don't want to send them to the line again. A little bit of hesitation on the part of Minnie Turner. All right, there's Tyree Anderson again.
Ooh.
The sidelines are a dangerous area.
Very much so.
Just a little bit too hard.
They're the same team. They're all fighting for the ball.
They got to be careful here.
Got to be careful.
Right.
There they go. There's Asia.
There's that sky hook.
Oh. Lady Dragons. Right.
They're on the sideline. That's a nice
watch
drive.
That reach.
She traveled again.
They got to travel. Ball coming back MLC direction.
You're always trying to get away from those sidelines. Sometimes you make mistakes. Okay, here comes Tiara Turner replacing her sister.
It's Tiara.
It's a 3-point lead for MLC with 2:46 left.
Ball's
it's coming back the other way.
Greater Hartford Academy.
All right. And if you saw that at home, 24.
Yep.
For Academy of the Arts, she got away with a little bit of a walking screen, so we'll keep an eye on that.
There's Tiara Turner. She's calling it. She's trying to set it up. That's good, Mike Winika. You take your time. You start thinking about it.
Mm-hmm.
Give everybody a chance to set.
I mean, you have a lot of emotions. It's a championship game, and you don't want to be going too quick here. There we go. Levin in
is good. Excellent job. It's now 16. 11, 2:11 on the clock.
And MLC gets the rebound. She's got to be careful with it. Here comes Levin.
Here comes
she can
MLC.
Go coast to coast.
Oh, ooh,
she's been so. I hope she's okay. She's really playing her heart out today.
Okay, looks like she's up.
It's the risk involved when you have a player who plays that hard. They can really get themselves hurt.
Right. Tiara Turner talks to her, gets all settled. All right, here we go.
Come on. Oh, she got right in there and the foul. It's plays like this that can really let you
here
slip.
Here we go. This is the thing we were talking about.
That lead can start getting chipped away quickly.
Now, Greater Hartford Academy. She's at the line for two.
It's a 3-point lead for MLC with 1:46 left.
1:46, 13-16.
Tara Farrell will try for that 3-point play. That's a violation.
Wow. 146 on the clock, 13-16. You're watching CREC TV this morning.
Oh, risky pass, but it paid off. Ooh, Tierra, got to watch that over the back. She got away with one there.
That was...
All right,
they take it now, 18-13, 131 on the clock.
She got that deadly sideline shot. It was nice. Right at the baseline there. Oh. It's a putback. There's a height advantage down there. Staying the same way.
114 on the clock, 13-18 MLC Dragons. And you're watching the CREC Athletic League Championship Middle School Girls Basketball game when we're broadcasting from the Learning Quarter here in Hartford.
It's a three-point lead.
Chair return.
Coast to coast, just missed.
She's got to watch those reaches, Mike. She's definitely got to watch those reaches.
Keep an eye on this girl right here, Tyra Anderson. She's got the hands of an NBA All-Star.
Just 1 minute. 55.7 seconds on the clock. 15-18, MLC Dragons. And Greater Hartford Academy of the Arts are taking the ball out.
Oh, she stopped her dribble. That's a good play again by Tyra Anderson. Defensive genius over there.
She's doing a great job.
Really good players realize when the player stops their dribble, you get on them.
That's it.
Oh, caught sleeping over there.
It's going the other way. MLC ball with 46.2 seconds on the clock. 15-18 MLC Dragons.
46 seconds. Come on, guys. We got to shoot. Run to the basket, Tyra.
Oh, here comes Tierra Turner all the way.
And
nice
she takes it. She went coast to coast. Oh, wow. 35 seconds on the clock, 15-20, MLC Dragons, and here they come.
With the shot.
Nope, didn't make it.
Uh-oh, oh.
Okay, here they come again.
Oh, nice pass, 16 seconds left.
Oh, did you see that, Mike?
That's a really quick couple buckets there.
11 seconds left, 15-22. MLC Dragons.
If you're MLC's head coach, you're really happy going into halftime after this.
Gotta go in. 2 seconds left on the clock. And that's it at the half. It is now 15-22 MLC Dragons.
If you're MLC, you're extremely happy going into halftime finishing that strong. That's a great job.
That was a great job. Okay, good morning. We're here with Bo Ryan, principal of Greater Arts Academy over in Hartford. His Lady Pirates are here. They're in the championship. Mr. Ryan, what's your feelings on the game so far?
I feel we're going to come back. Girls are playing hard, and we'll be ready for the second half.
All right, what do you think about the athletic program?
Unbelievable. Great job by John Weiner, the AD.
All right. Mr. Ryan, we thank Slot. What do you look at as the future? What do you see as far as what the athletics is going to do for CREC?
CREC dominating the state again in athletics, academics, and creating great places for kids.
Mr. Ryan, thanks a lot. Enjoy
thank
the
you,
game.
Sir.
Take
great
care.
Job.
All right. I'm here with Gary Woodfield, head coach of the Lady Dragons. Gary, what do you feel?
Feeling really good right now. Our ladies, we're down a couple ladies today, but they're really playing their hearts out. They've been getting better and better every game. This is for everything for us. They've been working for this their whole way through.
Great. What do you feel about the going into the second quarter? What's the strategy?
Basically for us, we're going to try to slow their number 23 down. They have a great team. Number 23 is an excellent athlete. Try to get her out of her out of what she's doing that defensively. Offensively, we got to try to set it up a little bit better. We got to try to get the ball to the middle more and dish it back out. One thing we haven't been doing really well today is running the set offense. Fast break's been working, but nothing. As far as the regular offense, we haven't really been able to get that going yet.
All right. Coach Woodfield, thanks a lot. Good luck.
Thank you.
Okay. Well, we're going to try that again.
Here we go. 6:49 on the clock.
Arts Academy is starting strong, but there's Tyra Anderson again.
There
we go.
There she goes.
They do a nice job of kind of hanging back in case of the steal. They really have a lot of faith in her defensive ability.
Most definitely. 15-24 with 6:26 on the clock.
There she is again. She must have at least 10 steals by now.
There she goes. That's going to sink before this game's out. She just keeps trying.
That would have earned a score of 9 at the Winter Olympics for ice dancing, I think. That was a great shot. Almost went in. Easy layup.
Oh, she was. Nobody was there.
Nope.
No one was there.
Got to play heads-up defense. Can't let up.
17-24, 5:59 on the clock.
Tara Turner slowing it down a little bit here. Doing a nice job of passing and cutting. That's a good look by Tyra.
Nothing but air, but they still hold the ball.
Championship teams know how to spread the ball around. That's a good look. Oh, she smothered immediately. Tyra Anderson.
That was nice. I wasn't expecting that at all. Uh-oh. 26-17, 5:28 on the clock in the third.
Oh, they're coming down quick. They're not wasting time at all.
Mike, have you noticed how they're opening up the middle and they're allowing Greater Hartford Academy to slip in the middle
there? Like, it's like opening up a garage door and just pulling the car in.
There you go.
They got to shut that door.
19-26, MLC Dragons, 5:10 on the clock in the third.
Coach is making the adjustment, making sure they can't get down that lane again.
Oh, yeah.
There we go. There's that help defense that they needed. There, see how
there
it pays off?
There it is. It's Tierra Turner. She's going coast to coast. No, she doesn't make it. They're up with it.
Almost.
Nope, not yet. Nope. Well, they still got the ball. There's Tierra Turner. Almost. That was the closest it's been.
Oh, I think she's out of bounds. Great effort. Sometimes in those situations, you just got to reset it, get it right back out to the point guard, and set something up.
She's taking a beating.
Yes, she is.
She's shaking it off.
It's a 7-point lead for MLC, 26-29, 4:42 left on the clock. Here comes Tyra Anderson.
All right, there it is.
Great look down low, but she just had somebody on her.
It's all right. Here it is.
It's a back and forth game now.
Oh,
great steal by Levin.
That was awesome. That was awesome steal.
That was hustle 101.
4:19 on the clock, 19-26 MLC.
Driving in. I don't think it counted.
I don't think so.
Nope, it did not. MLC ball. Oh, they're caught sleeping. Gotta be paying attention at all times.
Gotta pay attention.
See, look at this. They're not looking at the ball right now. I don't know what's going on.
It's Tierra Turner.
Just got to get your head in the game.
It's Asia Livingston.
That's that baseline shot she's so good at.
Oh.
It's a quick pickup.
Ooh.
Hey, it's coming back.
It's coming back.
Coach Mack giving a little bit of a defensive adjustment here.
3:45 on the clock in the third, 19-26.
Shots up. Just in and out kind
of deal. Look how that came out again.
Tierra heads up, turns around. Easy layup.
She takes it with an easy layup. 28-19, 3:25.
They got to turn around on defense. They got to keep their heads in the game. Otherwise, that's going to keep happening. I get on my players and they do the same thing. They come down at the court. They're not looking backwards and
Most definitely.
Come right
now. These
there.
Lady Dragons, they're about 13 minutes from a state chip from a league championship today.
Yep, they got to keep the pressure, though. They cannot let up.
They cannot.
Stop!
3:21 on the clock in the third.
There's Tara Fair again. Jump ball again. And it's coming back. See, now every now and then, those jump balls, they earn you a trip back to your side.
Yes, they do. 3:15 on the clock, 19:28. Say Dakota Rawls of Lady Pirates. She's a little tired, but she's worked extremely hard today.
As has Tara Fair. They're going to pull Tara Fair, I think, because of the foul trouble. You don't want to lose one of your better players.
That's right.
A little confusion on the sideline. I don't know why they're saying it's blue ball. The ball is clearly orange.
I don't understand that at all because they said it was blue ball, but it's 3:09, 19:28 on the clock.
Staying this way.
No, it's not. They reset it.
Rebound!
There's only one
team foul.
Come on, rebound!
Oh, they give us? Oh.
Come on, baby! Okay,
Minnie Turner has the ball, and it looks like she's doing a little bit of carrying.
19:28, 2:41 on the clock.
Is that foul wrong?
Yeah.
The foul! It was given to the wrong team.
Right.
Get the fouls.
Okay, the Academy of the Arts will inbounds from the baseline. Oh, there's 23, Tara Fair. She finds herself open down underneath the rim the whole game.
Yep.
So it should be 1-2.
It should be.
No.
No, no.
It should be 2, and then we should have 1.
Ref.
Monique.
2 for them, 1 for us.
Okay, Fair will shoot her second free throw, and it is good. Nothing but net on that one. Almost earned a steal there. Good look down low to Little Turner. Great job. Look at the height advantage. No fear taking that shot.
Get up. Get the middle. Box out.
Ooh. Nice.
It should be 2-1 on the fouls. It's, you got 3, you got 1-3. It should be 2-1 on the fouls.
Yeah, but we're going to have you. Oh, yeah,
correct.
Put it right here. We'll put it right here for now. Thank you so much.
Okay, because they got, she got 1-3 on the board. Okay.
Okay, MLC is at the line for 2.
It's a 10-point lead for MLC, 30-20 with 2:04 left.
This is changing right now.
Okay.
It's still wrong.
Yeah. Oh, almost gets her own rebound, but there's Tyra.
And there's a travel call ball coming right back to MLC with
way.
2 minutes on the clock in the third, 20-30. Okay, now we got everything. It's all set on the board. This crowd is getting a little
really
hostile.
Quick pass. I don't know if that shot counts.
32-20.
The shot counts.
58 on the clock.
Here's a potential three-point play. Tyra Anderson, the defensive mastermind on this team. Trying to make it a 13-point lead here with 1:58 left in the third quarter. Tell you what, right now, MLC's playing championship basketball.
Yes, they are. Ball's going back.
It's traveling again.
Get this referee out of here.
Okay, the crowd seems to disagree, but that was clearly a travel. Boys in Stripes doing a good job today.
Oh, yeah. 34-20.
That is a 14-point lead. Here comes Tara Fair. Look at wide open. Three's in. There's that good defense where you're not fouling, but you're getting your hand on the
getting
ball. That's a nice job.
Ball. Here we go. Here comes MLC again.
And
there's a quick
bucket.
Coast to coast, 36-20. That's MLC with 1:28 on the clock.
She's one of those players. She's like a LeBron James. She can just take the game over if she wants to. Tierra Fair tries the same thing unsuccessfully. That was a traveling. She fell with the ball.
Ball going. Great Hartford Academy, Lady Pirates.
Okay, it'll be inbounded down on the baseline. Academy Arts trying to put something together here and get back into this game. There we go. It's one of those pass shots.
Most definitely.
Sierra with a pump fake. Out to her sister, Tyra Anderson with the shot, almost.
Sierra's back again.
Oh, whoa. She stopped her dribble. She found her
that
sister.
That was a nice pass.
Yes. And Miss Levitin says, I don't think I'll take that back. There we go.
Okay,
coming back
go
the other
again.
Way.
45 seconds on the clock.
That's a foul.
That's
yep.
it.
Tara Farrell will be shooting two. MLC doing a much better job this quarter, this half, I should say, with their foul trouble. They only
most
have two
definitely.
So far. So whatever the coaches told them during halftime, it seems to be paying off.
Paying off tremendously.
That's fine. Okay, here's Tara Fair for her second shot.
Boom.
All right.
Very nice.
If you're the Academy
there
of the Arts, you really have
go.
To start chipping away at that
there
lead. You're running out of time.
38 seconds left in the third quarter, 24-36.
There's Tara Anderson again. Tyra Anderson, I'm sorry. Okay, they're going to set up a stack underneath.
24-36.
Oh, good look right underneath. She was wide open.
All right, here we go. 27 seconds left on the clock. Third quarter.
You got to step up on defense down there.
Yes, 26-36.
Cuts the lead to 10.
18 seconds on the clock.
I don't see him holding for one shot here. Oh, that's going to be an offensive foul, I think.
10.3 seconds on the clock, 26-36.
That's a bad call.
That was a defensive, that was a blocking call. It was a quick release by Tyra Anderson. 6 seconds left.
Here we go.
They need a shot here. I don't think they're going to get it.
And here it is at the end of the third, 26-36. Mike, right. I know you got to leave me. You got to get over to your boys.
Al, it's
good
been a
luck.
Pleasure. Thanks for having me.
All right.
Good luck to both teams.
All right, we'll see you later.
In an effort to promote good sportsmanship, please refrain from berating the officials. Thank you.
Going into the fourth quarter, 26-36, MLC lead, 8 minutes on the clock. MLC is about 8 minutes from taking this championship back to Bloomfield. We look forward to it. Exciting fourth quarter, 7 minutes left on the clock. Okay, as we go into the start of the fourth quarter, MLC Dragons 36, Greater Hartford Academy of the Arts, Phoenix 26. It's a 10-point spread. So here we go. Greater Hartford Academy of the Arts is going to inbound the ball. There they go. In and out. Ball's going back MLC's direction with 6:49 on the clock. 26-36 MLC. Let's go down the clock, 6:48, 26-36 MLC lead. And there it is. There goes Greater Hartford Academy of the Arts. Oh, in and out. And here comes Asia. There's Asia Livingston. She's coast to coast. Oh, it's in and out. Greater Hartford Academy has the ball. They go up. Oh, and she's fouled. And she's going to the line for two. 6:21 on the clock, 26-36, MLC lead. She sinks the first one. Now we have a 27-36 lead, MLC, with 6:21 on the clock in the fourth quarter. Victoria Vasquez sinks both. Now we have a 28-36 lead. This is still a great chance for Greater Hartford Academy of the Arts to come back. Since she goes back up the court again with a steal. Whoa, she misses. MLC has the ball. They're coming back down the court. 6:06 on the clock, 28-36. We got a whistle on the play. MLC ball. They're going to inbound it, and here we go. There's a pass. There's Asia Livingston. She's fouled. All right, she's going to inbound the ball. Go at 5:58 on the clock in the fourth, 28-36. They're stacking. The ball's going back to Greater Hartford Academy. Step out of the line, and it's going to be inbounded. There's Victoria Vasquez. She's up with it. Oh, it was in and out. Here comes Asia Livingston. She's coming back down. She's focused, and it was coast to coast, and she's fouled. And she's going to go to the line for two. 5:40 on the clock, 28-36.
Nice, that's a good job.
sinks the first one. That's now 37-28 on the 5:40 on the clock. A's 11 is still at the line for the second free throw. I don't think she's missed a free throw this entire game. She sinks. It's now 38-28, 10-point game, 5:40 on the clock in the fourth.
Shoot it.
Victoria Vasquez up for the three. She misses. There's Tara Fire. There she is. She's back to Victoria Vasquez. Jump ball. Whistle on the play. Great Hartford Academy has the ball, but 5:22 on the clock. 28-38. And they're off. There they go again. And we got 5:20 on the clock. 28-38 in the game. And 5:15 on the clock. MLC has got the ball. They're setting up. And there she goes again. There you go. Whoa, Great Hartford. Whoa, MLC's got the ball again. And there is Asia Liberty. She's going around. She finally sinks that hook shot. She's been trying to get that in all day, and she's finally got it. We're at 40-28 with 4:53 on the clock in the fourth quarter. There's Victoria Vasquez is in and out. Here comes Asia Livingston. Oh, she's got a traveling call. 4:44 on the clock, 28-40. Great Hartford Academy. In and out, here comes MLC. The Metropolitan Learning Center, 4 minutes and 35 seconds away from a CREC title here this morning. 4:35 on the clock, 28-40. All right. MLC's at the line for two. She sinks the first one, 41-28, 4:34 on the clock. Great Hartford Academy ball. MLC Dragons are setting up on the defense. And here comes Tara Ferris. She's got the ball. She's looking for Vasquez. Nope, doesn't work. She's going and fires up, nothing, up again, nothing. Okay, there it is. Great opportunity. Vasquez has it. Vasquez is up, misses. Here comes Asia Livingston. It's because she sinks that second hook shot for the day. We are now 43-28, 4 minutes left in the fourth quarter. MLC is taking this championship home, looks like. .356 on the clock. Greater Hartford Academy sitting with 18 fouls. MLC sitting with four. .356 on the clock, 28-43. There's Tara Fair. And she sinks it for two, 30-43. MLC Dragons. 3:33 on the clock. MLC setting up. They're setting up. They're setting up. There they go. They got this goal. And here we go. MLC, they're setting up. Livingston looking for the ball. She has it. She has it. They're throwing the ball around. There they go. There's Turner. Back to Livingston. Oh, there's a steal by Victoria Vasquez. But, oh, it's saved. Let's see, Livingston got a little laugh out of that one. She was right on the line. Yep, there it is. There's Livingston, and she's up. Oh, MLC for two, 45-30, 2:49 on the clock. There is Vasquez, nope. And here goes Turner. There's Turner, and no, she doesn't get it. Oh, All right, here comes good Hartford. They're coming back up. And here we go. Oop. Turner's got the rebound. 2:13 on the clock, 30-45. Metropolitan Learning Center. And we got subs coming in for Greater Hartford Academy. The art chair, Turner's coming back in. She is replacing her sister. Oh, they give us a little sibling love. And there comes Tierra. And we got a timeout, Greater Hartford Academy of the Arts.
We ask that at the conclusion of the game, you stay seated for a brief award ceremony. Thank you.
Minutes and 13 seconds on the clock, 30-45, Metropolitan Learning Center going in with Greater Hartford Academy of Arts, 18 fouls, MLC 5. And Greater Hartford Academy of Arts is coming back with the ball. She tries to sink a three, all air. MLC has the ball with 2:05 left on the clock. 30-45, MLC. Looks like MLC has cleared the bench, giving everybody an opportunity to get in this game, this championship game here at the Learning Quarter here in Hartford, Connecticut. Everybody's getting a shot to play today. So they're stacking, MLC is stacking. Call for the play. There's the play. And they're up with it. And they miss. A minute and 43 seconds. 30-45 MLC. 1:43 left on the clock. This bench has been completely cleared. And everybody's getting an opportunity to play for Coach Woodfield today. As MLC is about a minute and 40 seconds away from the CREC championship.
On defense.
There's MLC again. Looks like they have the ball. MLC's at the ball. They're doing great. Going down the court.
You can't be calling me around. What? What's up, man? No, the girls are still playing, man. I'm a monster. You can't be calling me around on stage. I'm on stage, man. You can't be calling me around on stage. Yeah. Yes. All right, bye.
30-12 ML. 30-45 MLC. 1:05 on the clock. MLC's second string on the court. They're just top, playing with the ball, having a good time. And we got a backcourt call on MLC.
That's all right, Dragon.
53.7 seconds on the clock, 30-45 left. And MLC is at the line for two with 53.7 seconds on the clock, 30-45, 19 fouls for Greater Hartford Academy. They need one more foul and MLC will be going for 2-2, 1-1. Oh. MLC still at the line for two. 10 personal fouls on Greater Hartford. They still at the line for two. It is now 30-45, 48.9 seconds on the clock. They're trying to get it together here at the free throw line. Ooh, she misses the first. 48.9 seconds on the clock. We want to thank you for watching CREC TV, the CREC Athletic League Middle School Championship Girls Basketball Championship game being held here at the Learning Quarter in Hartford, Connecticut. The Metropolitan Learning Center League, Greater Hartford Academy of the Arts, 45-30 with 48.9 seconds left on the clock. All right, they're fighting for the ball. Both foul shots were missed, and they're fighting for the ball. They're double team, and here comes Great Hartford Academy of the Arts. A little hustle there on the court. Pass the ball around. See what we got here. No foul there. Oh, air ball, and the ball's going back MLC's way. With 30.6 seconds, and here comes MLC starters again. They're back on the court. They're going to finish out this championship team game on the court with 30 seconds left on the clock. Tierra Turner is coming up with the ball. She's slowing it down. She doesn't want to rush in. There they go, Abby. The ball, ooh, good off the top. But there they go, regained by MLC. There's Tierra Turner underneath the basket. Misses up again. Ooh, all air. And the ball's going back to Great Hartford Academy. 8.8 seconds on the clock. Metropolitan Learning Center will be taking the trophy back to Bloomfield this afternoon. They are 8 seconds away from the 2014 championship. This has been a very exciting game. Here it is. We're going to call this right now. 2014 championship, the Lady Dragons Metropolitan Learning Center have won the first CREC championship for the CREC Athletic League. Thank you so very much. Stay tuned. We'll be right back for the boys championship game between Two Rivers Middle School out of East Hartford versus the Metropolitan Learning Center, the Lady Dragons.